Happy Thursday, everyone. Welcome back. Congressman David Scott's annual health fair brings the community together year after year. Well, this year, he's fighting against the spread of COVID-19 by offering free drive-through testing. Please take a look at this very important conversation with the congressman and some of his partners.
First of all, thank you all so much for being here. I know you have very busy schedules. This is such an important time. And of course, Congressman Scott, I've loved having you on the show year after year talking about the importance of your annual health fair. This year is no exception, but you're also stepping it up with an all-important test, and that is a free COVID test. Tell me more about this.
This is a life and death matter. And we and my partners are determined to save as many lives of our Georgia people as possible. And I want to thank WXIA 11 Alive, you, Christine, the Atlanta Company. Please also give my regards to your president, John DeShane, who's been with me all these years.
Yes.
I just want to say, please, come to Monday's Mill High School on Saturday, August 8th. Be there at 9 o'clock. We can save lives, folks, but we got to get tested.
Yes. Thank you so much, Congressman. You're always passionate about your community, but we are in dire straits here, and I want to make sure we get to everyone. Time is of the essence. And Chief Merkinson, I want to turn to you. You're from Clayton County's Fire and Emergency Services. You partnered with this event. Tell us more about your role.
The Congressman approached us a few months back to determine how could we continue this vital and important event in our community to help continue to save the lives that the Congressman has saved through his health fair. So what a better way right now, given our circumstances with the pandemic, than to offer free testing. So our role is to get people into this site, get them tested. This is not the all the way to the back of the brain test that we're going to be doing. It's a real just inside the nostril test. It's a really simple test. The Congressman has been tested here at my facility, so he is speaking from experience. So
good.
Our goal is to get as many people into this site, get them tested, and get them out as quick as possible.
And Kyle, I want to turn to you now as CEO of Atlanta Community Food Bank. We are in such an emergency state. I'm not sure if people really realize that all throughout the year we have food insufficiencies. What about now during COVID? What are you seeing?
We've seen massive increases in the number of food insecure families following the pandemic. We already had 750,000 people who were food insecure prior to March. And then after the pandemic, we've seen that number go up by more than 40%. The food bank's been able to increase our food distribution by about 55% over the last 4 months. We're now distributing close to 10 million pounds of food every month. At the event that we're going to have on Saturday at Monday's Mill, we will be providing food to the first 1,500 households who arrive at the event. There's an opportunity to pre-register, and we encourage everybody who is facing challenges getting enough food for your family to go look up the event and join us.
Yes.
To get tested and to get some support with the food that you need.
Kyle, thank you so much. And Bob, I want to turn to you. It's great seeing you again. As president of the Georgia Association of Broadcasters, what will your role be during the health fair?
Our role has been to help get the word out through people like Channel 11, our radio stations in town, and the Congressman is a great friend of all broadcasters. We just appreciate so much what he does. We've been part of this Monday's Mill second Saturday of the month of August every year for 15 years. We support his job fair. And this is what broadcasters do, as you well know.
Oh, of course. And Nancy, final question to you. You are with the Urban League of Greater Atlanta. You are down there on the front lines. What are you seeing? How are people affected? It's not just food insecurities. It's jobs. It's money. It's roofs over their head. Tell us more about it.
It's all the basics. It's everything that makes life comfortable and quality. roof over your head, paying your utility bills, having access to food. I am so thankful to Congressman Scott for bringing us all together. So Urban League's role up for Saturday is we're going to get the word out to the African-American community in particular. We've been hit the hardest by COVID disproportionately, but we'll be there to also pass out information with resources for the community, for utility assistance, rent assistance, and re-employment. There are employers hiring. And so Urban League is working with them to support families to get through so we can power up and get through this.
And I want to emphasize getting our young people out. And this is my granddaughter, Kaylin. And Kaylin is out working with us to make sure young people are tested.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
got your test, didn't you, Kaylin?
Yes, I
did. All right, young people, bring the young people. And our seniors. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you to Congressman David Scott and to everyone involved in that important event. If you want to get tested, please mark your calendars. It's Monday Mills High School, Saturday, August 8th, 9 a.m. until 1 p.m. And we'd also like to thank the Office of Congressman David Scott for sponsoring that important segment.